I click the eyedropper and then choose Tracks Mesh up here in the outliner. Now it's going to wrap around our Tracks Mesh object. And let's mess around with the factor. And now you can see that is starting to smooth things out really nicely. And let's see what we have here. All right, so now we're getting that all the way to the back of the head. This is just going to be to test the concept of cutting out our head. This video is part of my new VFX course, the Blendinator, where I show you how to use basic VFX principles in Blender to turn yourself into a Terminator. It is jam-packed with all kinds of tips and tricks, so if you're wanting to use Blender for VFX, this is a great way to start and to support me at the same time. So head on over to blenderfrenzy.com to learn more. Alrighty, now that we have our ultra-refined tracking to our footage and added the skull so it fits perfectly, we are ready to start to create some negative space where we can cut out part of the footage. But if you haven't watched the videos about debugging the tracking errors, there are three videos, and they're really crucial to make sure you have an almost perfect track that's going to help eliminate any problems you'll have moving forward. So just make sure you go back to the last chapter and watch those three. There's one for smoothing out the motion, one for ultra tracking refinement, and one for focal length correction. But now that we have our ultra refined track, we're going to start to create some negative space where we cut out some stuff in the footage. And we don't need all of the stuff up here. As you know, if you've been following me through this course, I like to save lots of different iterations. We're kind of getting to a place where we're having too much information. So I think I only need these last two here. So I'm going to go ahead and right click and delete the hierarchy on these two here. But make sure before you do this, you have saved a blend file with those in there already. And I have, so I'm just going to delete those. I'm going to save this. That's just going to get rid of unnecessary data. Also, I think this lattice, too. I'm going to delete. We've got the refine here. Okay, and so basically we have this with the lattice applied, so that it's now no longer here. But if we need to, we can jump back to the one that still has that lattice. And then we can use that to adjust stuff if we need. Okay, but we actually don't want that. We want this one with everything applied. And I'm going to take this empty, and I'm going to press M and move this just to our top collection up here. And I can just title this empty underscore motion, because that's what is moving everything. It has the object solver with our motion tracking data. And so I'm going to disable the skull so we can still see this. And then let's come to motion tracking and make sure we have our head selected. This was something we created in our original one, but this has all of the glitches on there. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that as well. And on this one, I'm going to select everything here on 490. Make sure we're on our 490 frame, which is looking straight on. And we're going to go to reconstruction and 3D markers to mesh. And now we have these points over here on every single tracker that is in there. So let's go back over to the layout. Now we've disabled our motion tracking information here, which is fine. We don't need to see it right now. So let's do, I'm going to hide the empty here for now. And with this, the first thing we want to do, if we scroll out, you can see this little dot over here. That's where the origin point is. And I'm not entirely sure why it's all the way over there. So with everything selected, make sure we're in object mode. I'm just going to right click, set origin, origin to geometry. And that's going to put that origin right in the middle of the average between all of that geometry. And so basically these are points in 3D space, but as a mesh, and it's called tracks. So I'm just going to call this tracks underscore mesh so that we know what it is. And just like any other mesh, we can select it, tab into edit mode. And you can see we only see the origin point now. And that is because we have no faces and we are in face select mode. So if we go into vertex select mode, now we can see all of the vertices that make this up. And they act just like any other vertices. We can grab them, we can extrude them and connect them if we wanted to. We can delete them, same thing. But for this demonstration, we're actually just going to create a very simple occlusion mesh in three steps. The first step we're going to do is select all of the points here. And I don't need the camera right now. I'm going to hide that as well. Just get that out of the way. So select all of the points, go to mesh, and then select convex hull. And now we have this automatic mesh shape that has been made by connecting all the points together. And that's pretty awesome. Okay, so that's the first step. Let's tab back out in object mode. Okay, and actually let's go into the camera. Let's enable that again and just see what's happening here. So nothing right now because we need to make sure that this is connected to our object solver. So J. Now we can either add an object solver here, or I'm just going to take this and I'm going to parent it to the empty. So select the tracks mesh, shift select the empty, control P, and set parent to object to keep transform. So now it will move with the motion of the head because the empty has already has that object solver on it. And I'm doing it this way instead of adding like a sphere or whatever, because then I'd have to align it again myself, and that's just more work. So doing it this way, I don't have to align anything. Everything's already all aligned for me. But this is not the result we're going for. Like I said, this is only the first step. So let's hide that empty again. The second step is to add a sphere. And yeah, I said we're not going to actually be adding a sphere, and that is technically untrue, but we're not going to be using the sphere in the way you might think. So anyway, let's select this Shift S cursor to select it. And again, if you want to see the cursor, I've turned it off. Just turn it on there. And that's where we're going to add in a mesh UV sphere. Scale this all the way down. Bring it back on the Y. And then we're also going to parent that to this empty. Okay, let's hide that empty again and go into camera mode. And now let's position it roughly about, let's see where our head, the top of our head is going to be, something like that. And let's go to the beginning. We're gonna maybe we can scale it on the Y a little bit. Grab it on the Y and move that up. Grab it on the Z, move that down. It doesn't have to be perfect, but we're just gonna kind of line it up like this. And you will see why here in just a moment. Okay, so that is the second step done. Now we're gonna take this, and we're gonna join them together. So select the sphere first, and then shift select the tracks mesh. Control J to join. It's gonna join this one to this one. Okay, and this would almost be enough for what we need it for. However, you can see that the topology in the mesh is all messed up. So what we're going to do is we're going to do another step. On the third step, it's going to be a shrink wrap. Just go to frame 490. I'm going to go into side view here. We're going to add in another, this time cube. Let's go into wireframe mode here. Scale that down. We're going to fit this over here, just like we would do with a lattice. Well, maybe not that small, maybe bigger, because we're going to subdivide this. So let's just make sure that we have this filling inside the middle. We don't want it to be on any of the sides or anything. Just somewhere in the middle, like that. Looks good. And then come to our modifiers and add a subdivision surface modifier first. You can see that really shrinks it. And I'm going to actually Shift S and move this around. You know what I've also forgot to do? Let's select this one, Control A, and then apply that scale. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to take this one. Do we like that size? I think I like that size. But let's bump up the levels a little bit here. I'm going to uncheck Optimal Display, and then you can see more of the geometry that we're making. And then if I go into solid shaded mode, you can see that two here, and I'm going to bump it up one more to three like this. Okay, and so the next thing I'm going to do is add another modifier, a shrink wrap modifier. And for this one, we're going to choose the target. If I click the eyedropper and then choose tracks mesh up here in the outliner, now it's going to wrap around our tracks mesh object. So I'm going to hide the tracks mesh so we can see what we're looking at here. And we're sort of getting this a similar result. Let's also come up here and make sure wireframe is on, because I want to show you what we're doing. Basically, we're trying to create better topology on this, which we haven't quite achieved just yet, but we are about to make it a little bit better. So I'm going to just make sure on cage is selected. We can adjust the offset here like this, and that does start to make it better. But along with that, what I'm going to do is add another modifier, which will be a smooth modifier. Smooth modifier. And let's mess around with the factor. And now you can see if we adjust that factor, and then we can also adjust the repeating steps. That is starting to smooth things out really nicely. So we're going to just kind of adjust the factor and the repeat to get something similar to what we have here. And we could even add another modifier, another smooth modifier, just on the X location. And that would smooth that out in the front there a little bit. And again, we can adjust that to our liking. There we go, something like that. And then we can come back up here to our shrink wrap offset, and we can mess with that offset. I'm going to hold shift while I click and drag in this offset here. And now let's go into, well, first we need to make sure that the cube that we've added is also parented to this empty. So shift select. I can't remember if I did this. Parent, keep object transform. There we go. And now that moves with that. Perfect. And let's see what we have here. All right. So now we're getting that all the way to the back of the head. And for the demonstration on how to create negative space, we're going to keep this occlusion mask really simple at first, just to show the concept of it. And then later on, we'll add more detail. So let's go to wireframe, and then let's select this. And I'm going to adjust the offset here like this. There we go. And this is just going to be to testing the concept of cutting out our head. So what we're doing is we're just creating a cage around the head like this that follows directly. And we did it this way for two reasons. One, so that it's in the exact placement that we want it to be. So we can actually adjust this to be pretty much following the exact alignment with our head, just like a mask or helmet or something. And we did this so that we can smooth out the geometry so that we can model around it later with more detail. But for right now, I'm just going to make sure that everything, all of my hair and nose and chin and everything is all engulfed inside this little bubble cage that we have here. Perfect. Okay. And so that is it. I mean, we can come over here. This isn't all that important. But if you wanted to, we can right-click and then shade auto smooth. And then if we uncheck those that wireframe, you know, then we have this. But there we go. So this occlusion mask is doing a lot for us already, where it's minimal modeling for us, which is good because we want to make things as easy and painless as possible. Okay, so in the next videos, we're going to use this occlusion mask to cut out the footage and add a clean plate in the background. So when you're ready, head on over to the next one.